Welcome back, everybody. Shade here. This is back to Davy Jones' Locker, and this is episode 9. And as you can see, I've done a little bit of upgrading to my armor. It's Ingvar. I've got some things planned today in this chest right here. And if you notice, there's a little hole in the glass behind me. Well, I decided to take, advice. I watched The Dark Preacher and his videos of Davy Jones' Locker, and I decided that maybe some of his ideas were better than mine, because the ladders were a pain in the butt on many places, and I have a little spot over there to get up here, that you all have seen. Don't mind the smoky bricks there. I was hiding so I could go AFK. Yeah, I got some rubber trees up here right now, but we will get to this in a minute. Let me show you the new stuff. I will be expanding this at some point, and this stuff's actually growing pretty quick, so I'm actually seriously considering this as a form of diamonds, gold, and coal. I'm still contemplating and thinking and trying to figure out where I want to automate this at, but it so far has gotten me quite a bit of stuff. I haven't planted the platinum or the apatite yet, but I think I want to go with a bunch of the other metals, and pretty much see how I can get this to automate. And we just started the episode, so we'll come back in a little bit and see what's grown at the end to see how long it takes them. Nope, not there. Here. I got myself a world anchor, which is going to need an ender pearl soon. I've been going through my farm and getting the bags and combining them down, because if you actually take 4 bags and put them in a pattern like that, you get the next bag up, and so on and so forth. But I'm not going to worry about the bags right now. I've got a bunch of stuff in here. I moved my animals from over here, and I'm actually kind of surprised that no more have spawned in there. I might use that as a growing room, but I'm not quite sure. I'm going to be expanding my farm. So I picked everything up. I've got enough potatoes right now, and then I've got these potatoes and carrots and wheat to make bread, so I'm okay. I've got to put all the endstone for the ender lily seeds. And then I made a pathway through here straight to my machine room. And it's kind of a pain in the butt, because I've got 9... I switched back over to lava, because these were just burning up way too much of my other stuff. So I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do, because this is like burning through my power. I've got this whole automated setup here for different stuff. Right now it's all sifting gravel, because I want more diamond blocks. I only have 4. I've got 25 redstone, so I'm not hurting on redstone right now. I've got a bunch of the stuff for applied energistic stuff, so we'll probably be getting into that soon for a better system. But I need to get my power figured out first, because even with my 5 million RF buffer here and my little 1 million here, it's still chewing through my power. So yeah, right now I've got it all three sifting gravel at the moment. Oh, that one could use some more. But once that's done, then I'll switch it back to the other system where it was sifting. This one was gravel, this one was sand, and this one was dust. Because I don't want to let up on my redstone at all. This one actually has all six, and it's pulling 146 RF a tick. So yeah, it's kind of bad. But anyhow, on to what we were doing. After I get a bite to eat. And this is all the stuff that I'm gonna use for Ender IO and other things. So, oh, one more thing. I'll show you where I moved my animals to. I am actually at the bottom of the ocean. Right here. Get in there. Get in there. I don't want to drown. Thank you. That's my pathway right there. And I actually learned this trick right here with the ladders. I learned that from the Dark Preacher too. He's got some really cool videos. His link to his channel is not going to be down in the bottom too. And I've got all my animals down here. Haven't quite figured out what I'm gonna do. Excuse me. As far as animals are concerned, I'll probably separate them out in their own pens and stuff, and get them breeding and giving me food and milk and wool and stuff like that. But one thing I have noticed is this place is very, very, very demanding as far as frame rates and everything. The video is pretty demanding because of the running water all over the place. So I've kind of been trying to find a way to do water breathing so I can actually go outside and cover my entire place in stone so that I could when I load in it's not as bad and you don't see the running water all over the place, because I normally like to start in here because it's kind of big dome area. It's where you start out at. It's probably where I'm going to end at. Well, maybe not. So yeah, all those running blocks get kind of laggy, especially when I'm first trying to load in. So, trying to figure that out. Oh, let's go check the achievement book real quick before we get started up here. Because I'm pretty sure I didn't do that. You know what? I can use that one area for that. You know what? Let's go ahead and do that. Ancient spores on a grass block. Okay. Ancient spores. What do you know? I got quite a few. Let's go ahead and come in here and start making this. How? Does it have to be next to water? I guess so. Well, let's go get a bucket of water real quick and try that. Bucket, 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 bucket. Where's my bucket? Oh, there's one. Grab a bucket and fill it with water. And I will probably start a whole which area in here. That's light, so let's just go ahead and, you know what? We'll do it anyhow. It's not working. Use. Nothing. I know I can get it out of this. Does that work? I don't think that works either. Well, if anybody has any tips on that, that would be awesome. Because I don't know what's going on. And I don't have silk touch to pick it up. So that can't happen yet. So we'll just put those away. And put the bucket away. Alright. What else we got going on? Place a wood barrel full of water near mycelium. I can see, I can't do those yet. I can't. No. Dolls to spawn Endermen and blazes by right clicking on a barrel of lava. Not gonna get into the dolls right now. I've already done this. And that's all that is. So we've pretty much gotten through all of this book. Let's see here. Where is there's that book. I want to try to find the main book again. What's that from? Simple Achievements? Yeah, that's not gonna happen. Because I can't go back. Because I wanted to find it. I think it's the dimensional thing is what is basically what I'm working towards. Which I don't see my book in here anywhere. Darn it. I think that was it, and I can't go back anymore. So, if we want to get into that dimensional thing, we have to get into RF tools. Let's see here. Dimension. Dimension Builder. That right there. Which requires a lot of stuff. Just a couple, looks like a couple ways to do it, maybe not. But we need Awakened Draconium Ingot, an Energy Core, two Ender Crystals. The Ender Crystals still need a Soul Binder, Emerald with Vibrant Alloy, Energy crystal, we're gonna need draconium ingot, wyvern stuff, and awakened draconium. And in order to get this stuff, that doesn't make any sense. Draconium ingots. Is going to be a little bit difficult to get because we have to get this native draconium cluster or the dust or the crushed ore. But in order to get the dust, we have to have the ingots or the ore, which we don't have. This is the main thing I want to use the reeds for. Draconium ore dust. How do I get this stuff? I think it's this one? No. See, it all requires that ore. Well, I'll look it up and figure it out, because I'm pretty sure it has to do with endstone. So, yeah. But on to the current project. We're going to get into where is it? Is some MFR, because I want the harvester. We're going to make ourselves a tree farm. Just because it has tools. You stinking piece of junk. The harvester. Now, the problem with the harvester is I'm also going to need a planter. But I'm pretty sure it will not do this size of an area. I think it's only going to do a 3x3. Is that... Why is that on? Oh, crud. Well, that's not cool. Well, it kind of is, but anyhow. And I'm going to have this guy actually shear the leaves. I think next time I'm actually going to bust into the bottom down there and in the bedrock, going to creative, bust in there and break out the wireless power thing, because that's not cool. Kind of feel like I'm cheating, but whatever. We'll get this started and we'll see what happens. I'm pretty sure I could put upgrades in here, but I think I'm only gonna need a 3x3. So let's see here. 1, 2, 3. I'll go down there and pick that stuff up real quick. So let's see what we're gonna need for our planter. Planter is this guy, which I'm gonna need a flower pot. Two pistons, a machine frame. I have the machine frame. I think I've got the copper gears. Let's run around and get this stuff together. No copper gears. So let's go 8. Take that out. Put that in there. And put that in there. And we'll make those real quick. What else do we need? Pistons. We might actually have some pistons in here. No, but we do have wood. Gonna need some iron. 1, 2. So I'm gonna need two pistons. I believe I have another machine frame right there. I'm gonna need a redstone reception coil, so I'm gonna need two pieces of redstone, which I do believe I have sitting over here. Two plastic sheets. And a flower pot, which is bricks and clay. Okay, do I have the clay in here? No. I have clay up here. Somewhere. Gonna need three pieces of clay. Least I know where everything's at. Yeah, I had to put this around here because I was like running back and forth across the room and jumping right when I was over the top of that, and I'd end up there when I still needed to be down here. It was quite hilarious. And flower pot. Okay, I need the gold ingot. He's done yet? Yep, there's the two gears. See, start the gears first and everything's ready by the time you're. So, oops, not that. That. Redstone reception coil. And lantern. Oh. I didn't grab the. Why didn't you guys stop me? I need the cobblestone. And Fred was pricked to death again. He just keeps coming back for more. Yeah, I've got to rearrange all this, but hey, it works for me for right now. The reason I am probably not going to make a base in the Nether is I pretty much already tried and died because the pigmen were getting too much, and so I killed some. Well, the problem is more spawned after I killed those, and when I left and came back, apparently the ones that were still there told them about me, and yeah, they were not very happy at all, so I died. Talk about a pain in the butt. Really? I need two more pieces. Ugh, stupid glitchiness. Two more pieces of redstone. Not that one. That one. And I'm gonna go ahead and dump that in there. I have four blocks of diamond. I want more! Maybe I'm just being greedy. No. There's the two pistons. And done. Now, the tricky part is with this is it has to go in the middle. I'm not sure how well this is going to work. I may actually have to get upgrades for both of these. But... ow. There we go. Off. I'm not going to set up the filter right now. I'll set that up later. But let's go ahead and grab some saplings. Can I reach that guy? No. Can I reach him now? Yes. Let's see here. Do we want to upgrade the radius? No, I don't think so. Not right now. But I am going to need item conduits to... build myself a little working platform that I will probably wind up falling off of. Okay, so this... no. That actually... oh, crap. Goes in. Oh, you know what? We need some filters. So I need some paper, which I have some, and I need hoppers, and I have some. I'm going to make all of these filters because I've been thinking about it, so. Okay. Alrighty, so now, we go into here, put a filter on here, and we take one of these saplings back, whitelist, Sapling. Oak sapling. On Green Channel, yeah. And then we'll come over here. And we'll have it come out the back. Just like that. So that's going to put the saplings in there. And then let's see here, we get our barrels out. Now we go back upstairs. And we set. Oh, I'm gonna need some apples. What am I doing? I can just jump down. Apples, 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 apples. There's some apples. Just do that. Put that there, that there. Don't have any oak wood. Whatever. This one is going to be apples on brown. No. That's gonna be oak wood. Hey, at least I have one now. And this is actually, this one's gonna be brown. This one's gonna be red. This one's going to be brown and it's going to have oak wood. And then this one is going to have leaves. Oh, I need to connect that. There we go. Oop. Just like that. Active without signal. And that should. I should do it. Okay, so we started out with 54 apples, 4 wood, actually a whole lot more wood than that. And since this is my wood area, I'm not going to actually hook this up, but I am going to put my oak wood in it so I can get it out of my system down there. So let's go ahead and go grab all the oak out of here. I'll make those back into. Turn that in, turn that in. Alrighty, we're getting somewhere now. Why did you stop? Idle work. What's the deal? Okay, so yeah, whitelist oak saplings on green. Think I'm gonna have to make the leaves something else. Lime. It's not. See, now it doesn't have the. Oh! It filled up in my inventory, not. Okay, whatever. Okay, so I'll just have to get power over this. So that means I can make this go back to green. And we will run our power. You know what? Power needs to go down there too. So I will make a painting machine and get all this up and show you how I made that and everything before next episode. You know what? This can actually go in the same place. I love that about these cables. So we're just gonna come straight across here. And if you all have a better idea on power, that would be awesome, because this is just ridiculous. And it's got power now. Why aren't you working? Oh, the channel colors weren't the same, so it wasn't putting it in there. Done. Awesome. That is so cool. All right. So I guess I can take these blocks and put there and there. And you know what? I might make this bigger. So, oh, I already put the dirt somewhere else. I'm gonna put it in here. Yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and fill this in. And I'm just gonna leave it alone. And next time we'll see just how much is in there while I wait for my diamonds to come in. Alrighty. We have an automated tree farm. That is so awesome. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Especially when stuff works out the way that you want it to. It's just awesome. And there it goes again. Well, everybody, thank you for coming. Really appreciate it. I appreciate the support. And I hope you enjoyed this episode. Finally got a tree farm up and running so that we can have a constant stream of leaves. Because that's what I'm going for. Because I want to make dirt. Because dirt don't hurt. No, I want to expand my farm and automate it. So in order to do that, I need dirt. So what I actually should do is I may actually have that barrel export out straight down into my composter. I think that would be really cool. So, and then this actually go into a barrel rather than this. Or I may just actually take that barrel up there, move it down here for dirt, and then just have all the leaves go straight into this thing. I think that'd be cool. Because I've already got quite a bit of dirt right here. Well, I hope you all enjoyed, because I certainly did doing it. It was fun. I had a lot of fun doing this. I always have fun playing this, so. Well, okay, maybe not always. Anyhow, thank y'all for coming. And don't forget to go check out all of my inspirations. I have all the links in the down below, especially Dark Preacher. He has the same series on his channel, although, unfortunately, I talked to him about it. I'm like, dude, where's the end of it? And, apparently he tried to place something and his world crashed, and he didn't want to start over again because apparently he had an issue with his world getting corrupted once before, had to start over. So we are going to stay away from that. And he said it's in Thaumcraft. It's Thaumic something or other. So, I think it's the... It's in something in the Thaumcraft, but I can't remember what it is exactly, so we'll probably just stay away from Thaumcraft unless I can find something to give me water breathing so I can fix my base. But thank you for coming. I'm still Shade. And I'll see y'all on the flip side. See ya.